when we're working in Fusion, we can make all kinds of sketches and splines and different geometry. Sometimes we may have geometry already created in another program, such as Illustrator, Inkscape, or another vector program. We can export these files as SVGs or DXF files, and then we can import them into Fusion and use them as sketches for extrudes or sweeps or any other thing that we would use sketch entities for. There are a number of different ways to insert a sketch into Fusion. First, we want to go up to the Insert menu, and then we can select Insert SVG or Insert DXF. If I select SVG, I can select this SVG that I've already uploaded to my project, or I can click Insert from Computer. Here I have an SVG on my desktop. I'll select it and click Open. Then Fusion asks, which plane do you want this to go on? I'm gonna click this plane, and it brings it in as a sketch, and it may be large. Go ahead and scale it down, move it into position, and then you can rescale it as you wish. And this automatically creates a new sketch. And then I can press OK. And now I have this sketch here that I can edit. I can also click these entities and do an extrusion. I can make them go out, or I can have it cut all the way through if I want to have an M hole through my device. Of course, I could use the sketch command in Fusion, but to lay it something out with topography or to make a complex design, importing in SVG or a DXF works really well. So if you want to upload to your project folder, just click on your data panel. Here you can see the SVG that I've already uploaded. You can click Upload, then select your files. And this time I'm going to upload this DXF file of the same design. Then click Upload, close the window, and now that's uploading. I can go ahead and insert an SVG, and this time I'll click the one that's in the cloud. I'll select the top face this time. And then, of course, it may be large or not rotated the same way that you want it. Go ahead and move it and make it the adjustments that you need. And then click OK. And so now I have a new sketch on the top, but this time it's referencing an image that I put up into the cloud. So hopefully you have a lot of fun bringing in your designs and using them for extrusions and patterning on your objects in Fusion 360.